Hello students and welcome all in the first English lecture of 12th standard academic year 2021-22. In this video I am going to explain the new syllabus to you as well as the introduction of first chapter, which is An Astrologer's Day by R.K. Narayan. Okay, so let's first see our syllabus of English. Yes, this is your cover page of English Yuvak Bharati textbook, and these are the contents. Okay, in the contents you can see section 1 is of prose. You will have 8 lessons, means 8 prose are there. Then in section 2 is of poetry, and again the 8 poems are there for our study. In section 3 is of writing skill, and there are 6 writing skills for our study. And in section 4, genre drama, means novels are given for our study. Three novels are there. Okay, so this is our syllabus, contents of the syllabus. Okay, now let's see our section 1, which is of prose, and 1.1, An Astrologer's Day. So An Astrologer's Day is a wonderful and interesting story, and I'm very sure that you will enjoy this thoroughly. So let's get started. At the very first, An Astrologer's Day. In the title, what is mean by astrologer, or who is astrologer? Yes, students, astrologer is a fortune teller who is or who will tell us about our future. It's called astrologer. Okay, and this story, this interesting story, is written by renowned author R.K. Narayan. So let's introduce the author, the famous author. Yes, R.K. Narayan, born 1906 and died in 2001. Rasipuram Krishnaswamy Iyer Narayan Swami was one of the best known novelists among Indian English writers, and has authored numerous novels, short stories, travelogues, non-fiction, and memoir. So what is memoir, students? Memoir means personal best writing, means he has written some stories which based on his personal experiences. Okay, he also created the imaginary town of Malgudi, where realistic characters in a typically Indian setting live amid unpredictable events. R.K. Narayan was introduced to American readers through many of his books and has won the Sahitya Academy Award, the most coveted literary honor in India. Yes, coveted, well desired. Okay, so his writing is uniquely Indian, mainly Indian, humorous, utterly charming, and authentic. Narayan typically portrays the peculiarities of human relationships and the ironies of Indian daily life in a graceful and simple style. Okay, so this is our author. Now let's see the lesson, An Astrologer's Day. Yes, punctually the astrologer spreaded his professional equipment in front of him, which consisted of a dozen cowrie shells, a square piece of cloth, with obscure mystic charts, then a notebook and a bundle of Palmyra writing. His forehead, see students, here given, the writer has given here the outer appearance of the astrologer, and which was very much suitable to his profession or for his profession. Okay, what was his or how was his outer experience? See, his forehead was resplendent with sacred ash and vermilion, bright red colors. We can say in Hindi or Marathi, tika, vermilion, bright red colors, tika on his forehead. And his eyes sparkled with a sharp abnormal gleam, which was really an outcome of a continual searching look for customers. Yes, he was continuously searching for his customers, his clients, but which his simple clients took to be a prophetic light and felt comforted. Okay, so all this outer appearance of the astrologer, just I told, suits very much to his profession. Now, he just always sat under the boughs of a spreading tamarind tree, which flanked the path running through the town hall park. Yes, now the astrologer was as much as a stranger to stars as his innocent customers were. Means the astrologer was not at all studied, or he was not at all very much skilled in astrology. Okay, yes, the astrologer did not really know astrology, but by his study, practice and shrewd guesswork, he could say pleasant and astonishing things to his customers. Astonishing means surprising, means he used to tell astonishing, surprising things to his customers to convince them. Okay, and he generally knew about mankind's trouble, how the mankind or a person suffers from the troubles of or in his life. Okay, now where his used to sit, there was no municipal lighting arrangement. So he used to work in a light which came from other shops. Okay, yes, the astrologer were, or the astrologer every day work hard, this whole day he work hard, he search for his customers. He just he does his guesswork, shrewd guesswork, and the astrologer's earning was a result of his hard work, of whole day. Even though he did not really know astrology, he did a good job of delighting and convincing his customers by telling them what they wanted to hear. So it was as much as an honest man's labor as any other, right? So he deserved the wages he carried home at the end of the day. Okay, yes, students. So some part, means only two or three paragraphs I have just given you the idea, the summary of two or three paragraphs. So the remaining part we will see in the next lecture. Till then, thank you, students.